Worst hit by the tsunami are children. Thousands have been orphaned by the storm. A shaken India has seen hundreds and hundreds of people volunteering to adopt these children. But now it seems that those good intentions will have to wait a while. Shikha Trivedi reports on why tsunami villages in Tamil Nadu are saying thank you, but no thank you to the kindness of strangers.
Children who survived the tsunami but saw both parents depart with a giant wave. This government orphanage has been flooded with requests to adopt these girls and boys. But those old enough to understand their situation don't want to go. Across relief camps and villages, in violation of all adoption laws, organizations and individuals are approaching relatives directly to take the children back home. There are many outsiders, but so far no one has agreed in the village of Samatampetti, where 10 children were orphaned and 30 lost one parent. While in some cases the extended family may have a monetary interest in keeping the child, 5 lakhs is the compensation for each orphan, people like Parmeshwaram still feel it is the best option.
Where they like, where they want to be live, there we can give them their comforts. That will be the best because they can grow with their culture and relatives.
Parmeshwaram and his wife Chudamani saw their 3 young children swept out to sea as they played on the beach in front of their home. But the couple have decided to put aside their grief and work for the orphans of the villages of Nagapattinam, especially adolescent girls. Overnight, many of them have made a lonely crossing from childhood into adulthood and its dangers.
As they are very vulnerable, we are also giving them orientation on different touches so that, you know, they don't get into the trap of abuse and molestation.
After the Kutch earthquake, the Gujarat government issued an order banning adoption of orphans. Orissa did the same after the cyclone, but by then several children had already been sold to outsiders. Sri Lanka has done it after the tsunami, and most people believe so must the Tamil Nadu government to protect the future of this disaster's most vulnerable victims. In Nagapattinam, Shikha Trivedi, NDTV 24/7.